Right then, let us take a small case study which is understandable to all of you, and then see how this design is completed and move further. So what is this you are seeing on the screen?
Line follower.
Line follower. Any other answers? What is the general name that we give for this hardware? Any generic name available for this device?
Robot.
Yes, it's a basic robot. Okay, so what this robot does?
Follows the line.
It depends upon how do you design it. It follows the line and it does a lot of other job. But the primary job of the robot is to navigate and move. So the movement, how it has to move, can be controlled by the designer. So he can actually control the way in which the robot has to move. I can design the robot to move in accordance with the line. In that case, we call that as a line follower. I can also make the robot to have the intelligence of avoiding obstacle and then navigate and move forward. In that case, I will call that as obstacle avoidance robot. So there are a lot of ways in which I can design the robot, but eventually the robot can move forward and backward based on a specific condition. Right. Now, let us say I am planning to design such a robot. I wanted to quickly draw what are the parts necessary for that. So how to design this robot? So what are the major requirements you can see here? So if you see from this particular diagram, I have wheels here. This is wheel 1 and this is wheel 2. Both these wheels are powered by two motors here. So we have motor 1. On the other side, you have another motor. Motor 2. Motor 1 is controlling this wheel. Motor 2 is controlling this wheel. So you need primarily two motors. And this wheel is called raster wheel. This wheel is not powered by motor. It can simply move around based on the torque generated by these two wheels. So this wheel is not powered by any motor. It is a simple wheel. So depending upon the locomotion or the movement produced by these two wheels, this will simply move. So this is not powered by any motor. So we need only two motors for, we call this as left motor and we call this as right motor. So two motors are necessary. Number two. So this is what is something which is very visible for me, and you have a body of the motor by a body or a support structure which is necessary for housing all the electronics. So we call this as body of the robot, and we have a lot of electronics here. Which I don't know what it is now. So some electronics we will keep it as. So that electronics is needed for controlling this robot. So the job of this electronics is to control the robot. So these are the three main components here. So I have essentially two motors, and these motors are controlling two wheels. And we have additionally a third wheel, which is not powered by motor. So we have two motors and three wheels. And we have a body of the robot. And we have the electronics part, which controls the robot. These are the three things that are there. So what is that I want? Job of this robot. Second thing is, how to control the robot. For that, you need little understanding of how to control the motor. Okay, so the robot essentially moves in the forward direction, in the reverse direction, and in the left direction, and in the right direction. And incidentally, if you don't want any of this, you will stop the robot. If the robot is running, it will come under these four possible conditions. Either it has to move forward, or it has to move reverse, or it has to move left or right. If none of these conditions are necessary, I will stop the robot. So for these requirements, how am I going to control it? So how am I going to design in such a way that the robot is controlled? So if you understand the physics of this, you need to basically know how to control a motor. Okay. So let me take a small battery. This battery is at operating at 12 volts. This is at positive terminal, this is negative terminal. I have a small switch. This is connected to a motor. Okay. So this is terminal 1 and terminal 2, A1 and A2. So when A1 is connected to positive of the battery, when I close this switch, yes, what will happen? The circuit is closed, and therefore there is a current flowing through this circuit, and this will make the robot to, or this will make the motor to run in some direction. We don't know what is that direction. Let us say it is running at clockwise direction. It can be arbitrarily running in any direction. For assumption, let us say that it is running in clockwise direction. So for running the motor to in clockwise direction, terminal A1 of the motor is connected to the positive terminal. Terminal A2 of the motor is connected to the negative terminal. Okay. So, second question comes, how do I make the motor to rotate in the anti-clockwise direction? To rotate the motor in the anti-clockwise direction or counter-clockwise direction, what should I do? Someone give me the answer.
So we should reverse the terminals.
So we have to reverse the terminals. So how do we reverse the terminals? Terminal
sir,
A1.
Connecting,
tell me.
Yes, sir. Connecting A2 to the positive and connecting A1 to the negative.
Okay, very good. So A1 has to be connected to negative and A2 has to be connected to positive. So how do I reverse connect it? So here is my battery. Here is my motor. This is terminal A1. This is terminal A2. So how I close the circuit? A1 is connected to negative. So this is my A1. A1 is connected to negative. And A2 is connected to positive. So if I reverse connect the terminals, In this case, the motor will rotate in the opposite direction. So it will rotate in this way, the anti-clockwise direction. So it's pretty simple. So if I'm going to have a motor, if I connect A1 to positive and A2 to negative, then it rotates in clockwise direction. If I reverse connect it, which means when A1 is connected to negative and A2 is connected to positive, you don't have to, you know, confuse what is A1, what is A2. You can assume this as terminal 1 and terminal 2. Keep it simple, don't complicate things. So if I reverse connect that in such a way that terminal 1 is connected to the negative and terminal 2 is connected to the positive, then the robot will, or the motor will control in the clockwise direction, anti-clockwise direction. So far, clear for all of you? So here is a motor. The top terminal we call it as terminal 1. Bottom terminal we call it as terminal 2. So in order to make the motor to run in clockwise direction, I connect the positive to terminal 1, negative to terminal 1. So the result of this is the robot will rotate in the clockwise direction. I take the same motor. Here is my terminal 1. Here is my terminal 2. I take the same battery. But in this case, terminal 2 is connected to positive. Okay. Terminal 1 is connected to negative. So in this case, the motor rotates in the anti-clockwise direction. It's a pretty simple physics that will tell you that you know, we can make the motor to rotate in clockwise or anti-clockwise direction by simply swapping the terminals. So what is the construction of the robot? So here is the body of the robot. I'm just drawing the top view, okay? So in the central terminal, you have the raster wheel. So on the left hand side, you have one motor. This motor shaft is connected to one wheel. So this is motor 1, M1. This is a left wheel. On the right hand side, you have another motor. The shaft of this motor is connected to another wheel. So this is motor 2, M2. This is connected to right wheel. Are you able to understand? So my objective is to, you know, here is the robot. My objective of this is to move the robot in the forward direction or in the reverse direction, or I take left hand side turn or right hand side turn depending upon my choice. So if you are going to analyze that way, if I'm going to control the motor in the forward or reverse or left or right, at the end of the day, your job as a designer is limited to controlling these two motors, M1 and M2. If you are able to control these two motors, M1 and M2, in such a way, it either takes forward direction or reverse direction, or left or right, whatever direction you want, you can control. So the job of a designer is to control these two motors. More specifically, how to control them in clockwise and how to control them in anti-clockwise. Let us take only one motor and see and construct a small circuit. But when I say I am constructing a circuit, why should I construct a circuit? because if I'm going to design a robot, the circuit has to be designed in such a way that it has to control automatically depending upon my wish and will, which means a sufficient amount of intelligence should be built inside the circuit so that the robot is able to do the job on its own. So we cannot manually go and do the changes every time. So when I say for making the robot to run in clockwise direction, terminal 1 is connected to positive, terminal 2 is connected to negative. And for the robot to run in the clockwise direction, terminal 1 is connected to negative, terminal 2 is connected to positive. So who will go and change this connections or swap the connections when the robot is moving? When the robot is suddenly moving, when the robot is moving in the forward direction, when I suddenly wanted to reverse the direction, the robot has to do the change automatically. So I cannot go manually and then change the connections from the forward to reverse and all. So the circuit has to be designed in such a way that the control, it is the control that I give from my side, swapping of the lines should be taken care of by the hardware. So that is the job. So how am I going to design a simple circuit which can automatically do the change of direction? So my job here is to change the direction of the motor. So I would give the change of direction from my mobile phone or from my voice, or somehow I will give the change of direction. Accordingly, the robot has to change the direction. So for that, there should be a circuit which do the change of direction. So how do I do the change of direction here? Okay. So let us take the motor here. So this is terminal 1 and this is terminal 2. Okay. So I take a battery as usual. I construct a small circuit called a H-bridge circuit. Let us see what is this H-bridge means. What is H? This is called H-bridge because it is looking like an English letter H. Okay, so let us see how this it is looking like an English letter H. In the middle of this arm, we put our motor. So here is my motor. So this is my middle arm of the H. So on the either side of the H, we put four switches. So I put one switch here, S1. I put another switch here, S2. I put another switch here, S3, I put another switch here, S4. So, since I put four switches on either side, so I construct the circuit and call this as H-bridge because it looks like an English letter H. So, let us construct the circuit. So, this is my first switch, S1. This is my second switch, S2. This is my third switch, S3. You can give some other name if you want. I can. This is my fourth switch, S4. So now you got it. Why it is called H-bridge, because it is looking like English letter H. Okay. So now, what is the job of this switch? This circuit will help you to reverse the direction of motor depending upon your choice, without physically disconnecting anything from the motor, and it will do the job automatically for you. Let us see how. Let us say case one. Case one, switch one and switch four, the parallel directions are, what is the nomenclature I gave? This is one, this is two, this is three, and this is four. This is one. I changed it two and three. That's fine. Leave it. So let us stick to this diagram. Okay. So this is S1, this is S2, this is S3, and S4. So one, two, three, four. Case one, I turn on this diagonal switches, S1 and S4 on. So S1 and S4 on. And this diagonal switches, S2 and S3, I put off. S2 and S3 are open. So when they are open, there is no connection. When I close these two switches, which is S1 and S4, what will happen? What will happen to terminal 1 and what will happen to terminal 2? Someone tell me. When S1 and S4 are closed, what will happen to terminal 1 of motor and what will happen to terminal 2 of motor?
Sir, terminal 1 will connected to the positive of the battery and the terminal 2 will be connected to the negative of the battery so that the motor will turn clockwise.
Very good. Excellent answer. So he is saying terminal 1 is connected to positive of the battery. How it is connected to positive of the battery? Let us trace this fellow. So terminal 1 is here.
Yes, sir.
So this is an open circuit, so there is no connection here. So you trace this fellow top. This is again an open circuit this side, so there is no connection. So this is connected to positive of the battery. So terminal 1 is connected to positive of the battery. Trace terminal 2. Terminal 2 is here. This is again an open, there is no connection. So this is closed. So you trace it here. This is coming. This is again an open circuit, there is no connection. So this is connected to negative. So I'll just, for your understanding, I am drawing this separately. You just have a look. This is motor 1. This is terminal 1. This is terminal 2. One is connected to positive. 2 is connected to negative. So if 1 is connected to positive and 2 is connected to negative, what is the result for us? The result is motor rotates in the clockwise direction. Agreed. That is case one. Case two. Now we'll turn on S2 and S3. S2, S3 are turned on, and S1 and S4 are open. Maybe I will draw that in a separate diagram so that it will be very clear for you. In this case, S2 and S3 are on. So this is on. This is on and this is on. And this is not connected. This is an open circuit. No, it's not giving clarity for you. What is the name? 1, 2, 3, 4. S1, S2, S3, and S4. So what is the condition? Case 2, S2 and S3 are on. This is on and this is on. These two are open. This is open and this is open. So there is no connection here. This is my terminal 1 and this is my terminal 2. This is the fast charging battery. So what will happen in this case? When S2 and S3 are on and S1 and S4 are open, what will happen? Exactly opposite to the previous situation will happen. What will happen now? Tell me.
The motor will spin in anti-clockwise direction.
The motor will spin in the anti-clockwise direction. Why it is spinning in the anti-clockwise direction? Because terminal 1 is...
Because connections are changed.
Connections are changed now. Terminal 1 is connected to negative and terminal 2 is connected to positive.
Yes, sir.
Isn't it?
Yes, sir.
So, in this case, the motor will rotate in the anti-clockwise direction. So, by using a simple circuit, by repeatedly switching on diagonal switches, and I am able to turn on the two diagonal switches at once, I am able to turn the motor clockwise or anti-clockwise. Right. Now you have to tell me, how do I switch off the motor?
Sir, open all the switches so that it will stop spinning.
That's all. So if you open all the switches, S1, S2, S3 and S4, all of them are open. If all the four are open, what will happen? The motor will simply float in the air. There is no connection here. There is no connection here. There is no connection here. And there is no connection here. Even all four, when the switches are in open state, the motor will simply float. It is neither connected to positive nor connected to negative. So therefore, there is no connection to the motor and the motor will stop. So that is what we have to do. Are you able to understand this basic concept, all of you?
Yes, sir.
Now, is there any chance? I'll give you another situation here. Switch 1, switch 2, switch 3, and switch 4. So this is terminal 1 and this is terminal 2. So let us consolidate our discussions. Case 1. Switch 1, comma, switch 4 on. Switch 2, comma, switch 3 off. So what is the result of this?
Clockwise spinning.
So this result in clockwise spinning. Case 2. I am getting background noise. Please mute it. S1, S2 are off. Not S1 and S2. S1 and S4 are off. These two are off.
Have you guys heard of off?
S2 and S3 are on. These two are on. These two are off. In this case, what is the result?
Anti-clockwise.
Anti-clockwise. I'll give you case 3. all S1, S2, S3 and S4. All of them are off. What is the result in this case?
Sir, this time also it will float, sir.
This time the motor will float, so the motor will stop.
Yes, sir.
We have seen three cases. In one case, these two are on, these two are off. That will make the motor to rotate in the clockwise direction. In the next case, these two are off. S1 and S4 are off. S2 and S3 are on. Maybe I'll use the separate color so that it will be easy for you to remember. I'll use pink color. So pink color for case 1. So S1 and S4 on. So this is on. This is on. This is off and this is off. So that will make the rotor to rotate in the clockwise direction. I'll use red color for case 2. Case 2 is what? S1 and S4 off. This is off. This is off. S2 and S3 on. Case 3, I'll use green color. All of them are off. This is off, this is off, this is off, and this is off. The motor will stop. I'll give you an interesting case here. Case 4. What will happen when the switches off in the same direction are on? When S1 and S2 are on, or S3 and S4 are on?
Short circuit will happen, sir.
So,
sir, I mean, it's no, a current, short circuit. No current will. Yes, sir. No current will go for the motor, so that the motor will stop.
And not only that, it will damage that also. Why S1 and S2 should not be turned on? If I turn on S1,
because they will connect.
You are basically trying to short circuit this battery. If I turn on S1 and S2, what will happen? If you replace this
battery, will connect.
Battery is positive and negative will be shorting. You are taking a battery and you are trying to short circuit the battery by putting a wire in between the negative. Do you understand what I am saying?
So yes, sir. Yes, sir.
You are essentially creating a dead short circuit here. So this terminal, this condition should never be exercised and you should never use that. So I don't turn on S1 and S2, which means
at the same time,
just in the same directions, I never turn them on at the same time. So that is not permitted. Similarly, S3 and S4 also, I don't turn on at the same time. That is also not permitted. All of you understood this basic concept?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now, coming back to our bridge again, this is my motor. Switch 1, switch 2, switch 3 and switch 4, terminal 1, terminal 2. This is the positive and this is the negative. I reuse this again and again so that it is easy for you, because I'm just testing this 5 times. So, for your understanding, for case 1, S1 is on, S4 is on, which means positive of the battery is connected to terminal 1, negative of the battery is connected to terminal 2. So this will make the robot to run in the clockwise direction. For case 2, S3 is on, S4 is on, which means these two are on, which means terminal 1 is connected to negative of the battery, terminal 2 is connected to positive of the battery. In this case, the robot will rotate in the anticlockwise direction. It is opposite to the previous case, it rotates in the anticlockwise direction. H3, when all the switches are in off state, the motor is simply floating, it is not connected anywhere, so the motor is said to be in off state. Case 4, if I turn on S1 and S2, what will happen? How the circuit is closed? Positive is connected directly to the negative. This is what we mean by dead short circuit. So this is never allowed. So never ever turn on switches in the same direction. Similarly, S2 and S3, this will also result in dead short. If you turn on S1 and S2 together, or if you turn on S3 and S4 together, it is a dead short. Now you consult it and tell me, what is the condition for clockwise direction?
Sir, for the clockwise direction, opposite terminals S1 and S4, opposite switches S1 and S4 should be connected, switched on. For the anticlockwise direction, S2 and S3 must be switched on. To off it, every switches must be switched off. And S1 and S2 or S3 and S4 must not be connected at the same time, as it results in dead circuit.
Right. In all our discussion, we always use switches in pairs. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
So what I do, I take switch 1 and switch 2. Sorry, switch 1 and S1 and S4. I connect them together. Switch 1 and S4 are connected together. I call this as input 1. So if I make input 1 as high, both S1 and S4 are going on. Input 1 is if it is on, or if it is high, S1 and S4, both of them are going to be turned on. If it is low, both S1 and S4 are going to be on. Or for your understanding, if I supply a 1 here, both switches S1 and S4 are on. If I supply a 0, both the switches are in off state. Why I do it? Because I want them to be operating in the same time. So it is always better you club them together. Similarly, I can always connect S2 and S3 together. Both the switches should be connected together. So I call this as input 2. So what is input 2? When I make input 2 as 1, both S2 and S3 are turned on simultaneously. When I make S2 as off, both S2 or S3 are going to be off simultaneously. So I have two inputs, input 1 and input 2. Input 1 is nothing but combination of switches S1 and S4. Input 2 is a combination of S2 and S3. Why I connect the diagonal switches together? Because it is easy for me to control them. Now, what is the condition for clockwise rotation now? I don't have to give four inputs. If I give only two inputs, it is good enough for me. So for clockwise direction, what is the condition? Input one has to be a one. If I put input one as a one, what will happen? Both S1 and S4 sir, are on?
Activated.
Activated. And what should be the case for input 2?
Input 2 must be connected to 0 so that...
So if I put input 2 as 0, S2 and S3, both of them are in off state.
Open.
So this will make the motor to rotate in the clockwise direction. For anti-clockwise direction, what is the requirement?
Input 2 must be 1.
Okay. Input 1 has to be a 0.
Yes, sir.
So if I put that way, if I make input 1 as a 1, input 1 as a 0, S1 and S4, both of them are off. S2 and S3, both of them are in on state. So that will make the robot or motor to rotate in the anti-clockwise direction. What is the condition for stopping the motor?
All input must be zero.
So input one is also zero, input two is also zero. And input one and input two should never be simultaneously on. So that is the condition. So this is how you would control the direction of one motor. So for one H bridge, how many motors we can control?
One
motor you can control. So for controlling, how many motors we need for constructing our robot?
Two motors
we need. So how many number of H bridges we need?
Two H bridges
we need. So in each H bridge, there is one master switch. This switch is called enable switch.
Which one, sir?
There is one master switch called enable switch. This master switch is connecting this entire bridge to the power supply. So if this enable switch is equal to zero, no matter what you give in input one and input two, nothing will happen to the bridge because the bridge is totally disconnected. So for clockwise and anti-clockwise, both should work. It is necessary that this enable should be a one. This is called the enable switch. This enable switch is the master switch which connects this entire bridge. Which is entire bridge? This entire bridge is connected to the power supply through this enable line. So for this clockwise and anti-clockwise operations should work, this enable switch should be a one always. So if enable is equal to one, and in addition to that, if in one is equal to one and in two is equal to zero, then clockwise will happen. If enable is equal to one, if input one is a zero and input two is a one, then anti-clockwise will happen. What will happen if enable itself is a zero? If enable itself is a zero, means this entire
no work will be happening.
Nothing will happen to the motor. Motor will go to off state. So if enable is equal to zero, that means the entire bridge is disconnected from the power supply. In that case, nothing will happen and the motor will go to off state. Okay, so one H bridge will control one motor, and for two motors we need two H bridges. What is a H bridge? An H bridge consists of three lines. What are the three lines? Input one controls switch one and switch four. And then I have input two. Input two controls switch two and S3. The third line is called enable line. This enable line is the master switch. This controls the entire bridge. So these three lines form one bridge. So for two bridge, how many lines we need? 6 lines. Agreed?